Hello friends, welcome to this episode of Science for Common Man. And today's question is, what causes different phases of moon? And in today's episode, you can expect simple explanations for formation of different phases of moon and at what location and when we will be able to see these different phases and why. Remember, this is Science for Common Man. Be ready for the simplest explanations with interesting animations. Let us have a basic understanding about the Earth-Moon rotation system. We all know that Earth is rotating around its own axis and it takes 24 hours or one day to complete one rotation on its own axis. At the same time, Moon is revolving around the Earth and it takes 27.3 days. To complete one revolution around Earth. Or in another way, when Earth completes one rotation or during one day, the position of Moon will change only by around 13 degrees. And another interesting fact is that at the same time, Moon is also spinning on its own axis. And the time taken for the Moon to complete one rotation on its own axis is also 27.3 days. That means when Moon revolves around the Earth and when it completes one complete revolution in 27.3 days, by this time Moon would have completed one complete rotation on its own axis also. And because of this peculiarity, always one side of Moon is visible to Earth. We never see the other side of the moon from the Earth. And one more thing to remember is that moon does not have its own light and it becomes visible only when the light from the sun reaches its surface and when that lighted surface becomes visible to Earth. Actually, in this illustration, I have shown moon and Earth magnified. The actual size of the moon is around 1/4 of the Earth and the distance between the moon and Earth is around 30 times the size of the Earth or 30 times the diameter of the Earth. So in an original scale, the Earth-Moon system looks like this. What it means to us is that since the size of the Earth is so small compared to the distance between the Earth and the moon, the shape of the moon seen from the different points on the Earth at any time will be identical. Now, coming to the interesting aspects of lunar phases. As we can see, Sun is always lighting up one half of moon and one half of Earth. When the moon is at this position, even though one half of the surface is lighted up by the Sun, that surface is not visible from Earth. That means Moon will not be visible from Earth. This is what happens during a new moon. Even though Moon is up there available in the sky, since its surface facing the Earth is not lighted, we will not be able to see the Moon. And now let us see what happens when Moon reaches here. Some part of the Moon becomes visible. When Moon is at this location, when we view from the Earth, the lighted up parts of the Moon have the shape of a crescent, or we call this phase as a waxing crescent. Waxing has a word meaning of progressively increasing. So here, the size of this crescent is progressively increasing when Moon moves from this particular point to this particular point. Many people think that the crescent shape is formed due to the shadow of Earth falling on the Moon. It is absolutely wrong. Even though it is true that the shadow of one sphere falling on another sphere may cause a shape of that of a crescent, poor Earth has nothing to do with the formation of a crescent shape on this case. To understand further about this crescent shape, consider a sphere which is lighted up on its one half and see what happens when we view it from different angles. See how the lighted up area changes when we change our viewing angles. This is how the crescent shape is formed. When moon completes one quarter of its revolution around Earth, it reaches at this position. At this position, we call it as quarter moon because it has completed one quarter of the complete revolution around Earth. When the moon moves further, its shape changes and it becomes gibbous shape. Gibbous means it is something like that of a convex. Here, when viewed from Earth, at this position, moon looks like a convex shape, and that is why it is called gibbex. And in fact, that shape goes on progressively increasing. So we call it as waxing gibbous. And when moon reaches at this particular point, we will be able to see a fully circular moon, and we call it as full moon. But we may doubt why at this point the Earth is not blocking the view of the moon and why Earth is not casting its shadow on the moon at this location. That is because the orbital plane of the moon is inclined by 5.1 degree relative to the line connecting between Sun and Earth. So light rays from the Sun can completely light up the moon's surface even at this position. As moon continues its revolution around Earth, we further have waning gibbous. Waning has a word meaning of reducing continuously. So the size of the gibbous continuously reduces, and this phase is called as waning gibbous. When the moon reaches at this position, it has completed 3/4 of revolution around the Earth, and this particular phase is called as third quarter. And when moon further progresses with its revolution, we get a crescent shape, and here we call it as waning crescent because the size of the crescent goes on reducing as moon progresses with the revolution. And finally, the moon again reaches the position of new moon, and the whole process repeats cyclically with a cycle period of 27.3 days. And now let us see at what locations and at what times we will be able to see these interesting phases of moon and why. It is interesting to note that if I am standing on the surface of the Earth, this is the time at which I will start seeing sunrise. And this is the noon time, and this is the time of sunset. And I always see sunrise to my left, which is my east, and I always see sunset to my right, which is my west. And now about the availability of the new moon. Even though we are not seeing the new moon due to the lack of light, it is there up in our viewing angle from sunrise till sunset. Now what about waxing crescent? It starts appearing between sunrise and noon and continues to be there up to a time which is between sunset and midnight. At the same time, during the daytime, since the sun is illuminating the atmosphere, we will not be able to notice this waxing crescent present there till it becomes sunset. During sunset, when the sun disappears, the waxing crescent becomes more and more visible, and we see it during sunset and shortly after sunset when we look towards west. Now, first quarter moon. It rises during noon and it continues to be visible till midnight. Again, from noon to sunset, since sky is illuminated by the sun, we may not notice it, but after sunset, we will start noticing it till midnight. Waxing gibbous starts appearing to us after noon and it continues to be there till past midnight. Again, during the daytime, it's very difficult to notice it. We start noticing it after sunset and till past midnight. And now the most interesting, full moon. Full moon rises when sun sets and full moon sets when sun rises. So full moon is visible from sunset and throughout the midnight till sunrise. And now waning gibbous. It starts appearing after sunset and it continues to be visible a little while after sunrise. And third quarter, as we can see, it starts appearing at midnight and continues up to noon. In the case of waning crescent, it starts appearing after midnight and continues till afternoon. So friends, next time when you are out there for capturing stunning images of different lunar phases, please do remember these locations and timings and have beautiful images of different lunar phases. Thank you for watching. Hope you liked it. Please do subscribe and click the bell button to receive notifications about the future videos. Thank you. Signing off. This is Science for Common Man.